Again, Big Dave coming at you from beautiful Cuesta College in San Luis Obispo, California. Once again with me today is none other than the amazing Jackson Howell. Jackson is my technical producer. Jackson thinks he's taller than me now. I don't think so. Look at that, I'm still taller than you.
Dude.
Take this and get out of here, kid. All right, so let's do this quick review so you can do the Earth Sun exercise in a hopefully a short amount of time. Couple things. The term insolation stands for incoming solar radiation. That's energy coming from the sun that makes it to the earth, and the earth absorbs that energy. What causes seasons on our planet are fluctuations in insolation. In other words, changes in the amount of solar radiation striking the earth's surface. The main cause for the seasons is the tilt of the earth's axis. Take a look at the globe. It's tilted. The Earth's axis is tilted 23.5 degrees away from a perpendicular line. So as the Earth revolves around the sun, I'll be the sun here, the Earth's axis remains pointed in the same direction in the sky. Look at my talent here. Same direction in the sky all the time as the Earth revolves around the sun. So what happens is different latitudes receive different amounts of directness of rays. And that's what helps create the season. So the basic cause for the change of seasons on the planet is the tilt of the Earth's axis, which creates fluctuations in the amount of energy striking various latitudes. The circle of illumination, to help you do your exercise. The circle of illumination is the line separating the light and the dark halves of the Earth. If I shut the lights out in here and I shine a flashlight on that globe, I can only light up about one half of it. And that line that would separate the light half from the dark half is called the circle of illumination. Okay, there are a couple terms here. There's something called a solstice and an equinox. I know they're named after lame cars. Hope none of you have either of those cars. They're lame. Anyway, solstices and equinoxes. The two solstices occur June 22nd and December 22nd. The two equinoxes occur in March and September. For us here in Visalia, or San Luis Obispo, June 22nd is the beginning of our summer, 1222 is winter, 322 is springtime, and 922 would be the fall. So, let me grab something here to give you an illustration here. So, on your exercise, it's asked me to determine what seasons occur as the Earth is in different parts of its revolution around the Sun. So if this were the Earth's axis and this were the Sun, if the North Pole is tilted towards the Sun, that's June. And we get the most direct rays in the Northern Hemisphere. And as you probably know, we get longer days. So it warms up in the summertime for us. Now, when I get over to this position, where the Earth's axis isn't tilting towards the Sun like this or away from it, that's going to be September. Okay, so September, the sun's vertical rays strike more at the equator, and day and night are equal everywhere. That's kind of a mild season for us. A few months later, the Earth's in a position like this, where the North Pole is tilted away from the sun. So the more direct rays are in the Southern Hemisphere, we get less direct rays in the Northern Hemisphere, and shorter days also. That's the start of our winter. And then a few months later, we're back to springtime, where the sun is directly overhead at the equator again, and day and night are equal. And it's kind of a mild time of the year for both San Luis as well as Visalia. So when you do your exercise, here you go. So this is gonna be June. How do I know that? The North Polar axis is tilted towards the sun. Next would come the fall, right? And then the winter time. Right, where the North Pole is tilted away from the sun, and then I'm going to be back to springtime. So June, September, December, and March. At the bottom of the exercise, it asks you about the significance of these lines. And very briefly, I don't think I have the equator on there, but the equator cuts the globe in half. Day and night are always equal there. On your exercise, I'm going to ask you about the tropics and the Arctic and the Antarctic circles. So 23.5 north is the Tropic of Cancer, right about this direction right here. And it marks the northern limit of the sun's vertical rays. In other words, you can't go any further north than this, have a day, without where the sun would be directly overhead. Saturn's the best world is about 34 degrees north latitude. Visalia is more like about 36 degrees north. Neither of those locations can have a day when the sun is directly overhead. It's just too far north. This marks the northern limit of the sun's vertical rays. The sun is directly overhead at the Tropic of Cancer on June 22nd, beginning of summertime. The Tropic of Capricorn marks the southern limit of the sun's vertical rays. In other words, that's as far south as you can go to have a day when the sun would be directly overhead. The day when it would be directly overhead at the Tropic of Capricorn is December 22nd. The Arctic Circle, you'd have to go at least that far north to have one day when the sun wouldn't rise and wouldn't set. We don't have days like that in San Luis or Visalia. The sun always rises and always sets. You'd have to go that far north to have a single day where the sun would not rise and would not set. The day that it would not set would be June 22nd. The day it would not rise at the Arctic Circle would be December 22nd. It would be the opposite for the Antarctic Circle. You'd have to travel that far south to experience a day where the sun would not rise or would not set. It would not set on December 22nd, and it would not rise on June 22nd. So that would be the significance of those lines. If you could throw those dates down too, I'd really appreciate it. If you have to use, well, squeeze as much in there as you can. Okay, I'll be very generous on this one. I have the North Pole and the South Pole up here. So the North Pole, you have 6 months light, 6 months dark, which is kind of unusual. And at the South Pole, 6 months light, 6 months dark. So I think that's going to wrap up this exercise. And again, thank you guys for watching another installment, A Big Day at Equestria College Physical Geography.